Rise and Shine each weekday morning with Steve Johns here on CRMK.
Community Radio Milton Keynes on Channel 40 and 90.6 VHF.
Thank you very much. That's what you're listening to. And a very
good morning if you've just tuned in. It's The Breakfast Show on this Wednesday. And the weather forecast for today, dry and sunny to start with, but we can expect some showers later, which could be heavy with thunder at times. The maximum temperature today, about 18 degrees. The wind will be light, force 2 to 3 westerly. And the outlook, further showers and sunny spells. So avoid that stretch of the motorway if you possibly can. And coming up right after the next record, the second of our job spots.
Well, it all started off really when my dad died. I was about 11, 12, can't quite remember. And my dad died and my mum thought we would have a fresh start and move out somewhere new. When we got down here, you opened the door to your new house and it's full of adverts on the floor saying, "Welcome to your wonderful new home," and all this, and really it's a big military barracks. It looked like a toy town. It didn't look real to me because I'm used to all the grime and everything else, and it was so new and grass and all this everywhere. And where it just rained, everything looked shiny. And I kind of thought, do people really live here, or do they just do this to impress you? Then I looked over to where I was going to live, and I thought, oh, good grief. It was really horrible. Leaving school, I was pretty much fed up, you know. No money. Money was pretty tight, so I was getting fed up and annoyed with myself. So I started looking for jobs. And a couple I liked, but I didn't get them. All of a sudden, I see an advertisement in the paper for a tyre fitter. I had an interview in the escort, the works motor, because there was nowhere else to have an interview at the time. So I thought, well, seems different. And from there, I've got on, you know. But it's an interesting job, and there's a lot more to it than people think. You're always meeting different people every day. It's not just the one putting on and putting off. You're either doing a punch, you're on a car or a truck or a new tyre or a forklift. And you can have a crack with the blokes from the building site, or you get a mother in a 1954, whatever it is, with about 12 kids coming out of the boot. I like meeting different people and see what they think.
If you're looking for a new job, maybe a bit fed up with the one you've got, well, we've got a total of 11 jobs to tell you about this morning, courtesy of the local job centres. And right now, here comes the second batch. Job number 5 today is for a part-time domestic assistant in Walton. This is to work from 9 a.m. until 2.
The reason I came in the first place was because I worked for John Lewis in Portsmouth 2 years ago. We had a film on this new branch we had opening at Milton Keynes. I couldn't go any better in Portsmouth and I wanted to gain more experience in my job. And John Lewis seemed to offer a good opportunity to widen this in Milton Keynes. We didn't choose where we wanted to live because we didn't really know much about the area then, but each estate is quite different. There are the good and the bad. But we're quite pleased with Conybar. It seems quite a good estate to live on. 5 minutes walk from the shopping centre, which is great for shopping and for work.
Two banana bananas, 35 pence.
When we first came down, there wasn't many shops open. I think Woolworths was open and Boots were open. And although there was a lot of other shops in the precinct, they were all boarded up. But it was very clean and very big, and it was unlike other precincts I've been to. You didn't feel crammed in. It was nice and open, and the trees and the plants, you know, helped give a nice atmosphere.
Search down, you find you stranger.
If you come to Milton Keynes and work in a small shop, you know, you've only got your boss and perhaps a couple of other assistants. It is difficult, you know, when you go out. Not everybody wants to make friends all the time. They've got their own friends. But John Lewis offer a wide variety of clubs, so they encourage you, really, to make the most of what's to offer around here.
Hi, what are you doing?
Tidying up this lot yet again.
You coming upstairs for a cup of coffee?
Yeah, I will in a few minutes. I've got to finish this lot.
Okay, I'll see you up there.
Okay, fine.
Bye.
And that was the real part that worried me, was the social life. It's a good start to have people at work, you know, to go out with. And then in time, you know, you do make your own circle of friends. But everyone that I knew had started John Lewis, and they had all come from outside Milton Keynes into the area, so they were as much in the dark as we were. So I think when we first came here, you really had to make an effort to find things to do in the evening.
How's the new department going?
Oh, it's lovely.
Is it?
Yeah. I have to get going to people to ask for help.
Oh, dear. Robert and I are going over to Stantonbury this afternoon to play a game of squash. Mm-hmm. Do you want to come on afterwards for a drink? I'm going to ask Corinne, see if she wants to come.
Mm.
That'd be nice.
I'm working tonight till late, so I won't be able to come home until I finish working.
Well, if you can pop home and, you know, get changed.
Yeah.
I'll meet you upstairs in the bar.
A few drinks.
Not too many. You might be.
I came here in 77 because we were southerners and we moved to Yorkshire. My mum couldn't settle there. We wanted to get somewhere south, you see. My uncle suggested that we come here because, as he put it, it's the great place to come. You know, everybody comes to Milton Keynes now. It's going to be great.
Good afternoon, sir. Can I help you at all?
I'm just having a look.
It's true what people say. To live here, you've got to have a car. It's the general comment. The buses generally finish up about 10:45. So if you're going to go anywhere decent, I mean, there's not a lot of places to go, and the places there are so spread out that to get home, you have to take a taxi.
Okay, thanks very much.
Thank you.
I think the centre's great. I'm not one of the people who knock the centre. You know, it's lovely and new, lovely and fresh. It's got everything you want there for shopping and for a day out and that. But when you've been to work there all day and you go home, it's like stepping through a time zone, as it were. Bang, you're in a different world. Everything stops. It's very hard, especially in the winter when the weather's not so nice. And you come out of there and you've been working and there's nowhere to go. That's when you realise how bad it is, you know, around the city. But it's dead in the evening because it is purely and simply as a shopping centre. It's not the city centre because there isn't any nightlife.
I think if you come to leisure centres, you've got to have someone to go with to begin with. You just can't turn up on a leisure centre to play a certain sport on your own. I've made friends at work, and we go out and you meet their friends and the friends' friends, and in a while, you know quite a few people.
Robert's just thrashed me as a game of squash. Again. I've practiced it.
Are you improving?
I'm improving.
So what's the social life like at Lloyd's?
Not too bad, I suppose. Yeah. We play 5-a-side last night. People from the bank are right, you know, go out for drinking it. But apart from them, you come up here. I mean, I don't know anybody up here since I moved up here. It's very difficult to meet people.
I think that's where we're lucky, though, belonging to a large organisation, because we have so many clubs. Whatever you do, we've got a club for.
Oh, we've got no clubs at all, really. Well, you've got such a big staff, haven't you?
Yeah, we've got about 650 people working for us, yes.
I suppose that's big enough. We can get a few 5-a-side teams out of that.
Yeah.
If you restrict yourself to Milton Keynes, you're a bit limited, aren't you? Have a few drinks.
A few more drinks.
That's what you do.
Drink. Oh, what else is there to do, really?
Well,
not a lot.
It's all saving flips.
Well, when we first came, there was one big youth club that didn't have a lot to offer, and a neighbourhood youth worker came down and said, would I like helping to do a coffee bar? So I thought, smashing, great. When can we start? A year later, and a lot of meetings, well, one coffee bar. And from there on, got to know a lot more interesting people. Everything from your six-year-old jobbo to your 18-year-old next prime minister. They've all got different opinions, which I like. I like seeing their point of view from mine.
So it's down to private cars?
Yeah.
Where I live is over the side of town from the youth club, and you've got to rely on a bus, or if you want to get down there quick, it's got to be a taxi, because it's a good half hour by bus and walking. You go up the city centre quite a lot.
I don't go up there a lot myself. Really, I think it's a waste of money. At nights, it's dead. There's nothing for people under 18 to do. You know, there's nothing there.
Nothing.
I mean, they spend £18,000 on some piece of sculpture that hangs above in the air.
Yeah.
It's a tin foil. That could have been spent on better things, such as a hospital or things for the youth to do.
Yeah.
Or many handicapped.
From Bletchley to Stoney.
From Tinker's Bridge to Bradville.
From Stantonbury to Galley Hill.
Uniting the city on 90.6 FM, this is your own local radio station.
CRMK, Community Radio in Milton Keynes.
Thank you very much, Shan. A very good morning. If you've just tuned in, welcome along to the...
Well, I wouldn't say Milton Keynes has become a place where you can, you know, you get someone to say, oh, I come from Milton Keynes. Well, you get people say, oh, I come from Milton Keynes, but they say, but originally I come from London, or from Wales, or from Scotland, or from Kent, or Newcastle. But you ain't got no one who can say that they're Milton Keynes, or whatever they want to call themselves.
This coming Saturday, there's a Great Britain Handball Championships. They're going to be taking place at the Stantonbury Leisure Centre. The first match is an under 15...
I don't say I don't 100% like it here. I do like living here, but I'd like it a whole lot more if there was more to do. But then again, it's a funny situation, because people are coming from London and places like this, because they've got poor properties. So they think it's lovely here until they settle into a pattern where they take for granted they've got a better property. All they're thinking then is, well, where can we go? What can we do? It's natural, it's, you know, it's human nature to think like that. I think for my grandchildren or even my children, it'll be great. It'll be, you know, lovely. If I stayed here, they'd be really lucky, because they'd have been brought up into it and they'd have had a family who lives here, which is ideal.
Travel situation for today? Well, good news if you're a bus traveller. United Counties tell us they have no problems, all the buses are running. And if you're travelling around on the roads today, the only problem...
I've lived in Portsmouth 11 years, so Portsmouth is home to me. But I'm also quite relieved to go back to Milton Keynes, which I also call home. It wasn't at first, it was back to the flat or back to Milton Keynes, but I suddenly realised, now I'm now saying, going back home.
The thought for the day today, and thanks to Fred of Stantonbury for this one, the thing to do with good advice is to pass it on. It's never any good to oneself. The weather forecast for today, sunny intervals, but also some showers, which could be heavy with hail and thunder a little later on. The maximum temperature today, 16 degrees, and it will remain unsettled with showers and staying cool as well.